Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to run your Java program using Notepad++. So let's begin. Now to run Java program in Notepad++, you need to first install these two software. One is Java and another is this Notepad++. Now I have already made a video on how to install the latest version of Java, that is Java 17, already in my channel. So I'll be again putting the link in the description, so you can just follow that video from that link. If you haven't installed Java, then you need to just install Java first, right? And then we also need Notepad++. So for that also I have already made a video. So again I will be putting that link in the description, so just follow that link and install these two software before proceeding with this video. But if you have already installed these two softwares, let's begin with this video. So for that, let us first open our Notepad++. So you can clearly see our Notepad++ has been rightly opened over here. So this is just a change.log file, so just, you know, simply close it, and you can see our new text file has been rightly created over here. But the thing is, first what I'll be recommending you is to install one plugin. So for that, just simply go to this plugins window and then just simply click on plugins admin. And now inside this search, all you need to search is NppExec, and you'll be getting this NppExec as a new plugin. So just, you know, simply check this and just, you know, simply click on install so that we can install this plugin. So just, you know, simply click on yes, and you need to just simply provide the administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes, and you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started downloading, and it has also been installed. So why we install this? We install this to get this console over here. See, if you just simply click on this console, you can see this console has been rightly opened over here. So in this console only we'll run our programs. So let's write a simple Java program over here. So class hello world, and just end with a brace, and then let's create our main method. So public static void main string args. String will be a class, so just, you know, simply make it as a capital S, then end with our base, and just, you know, simply going to print hello world, right? So system.out.println, it will be hello world, right? So go to file, then save, and it will, you know, going to open a new window. So just, you know, simply go inside this document directory, then just, you know, simply create a new folder. So let's give a folder name as a Java practice, right? Just go inside that folder, give a file name as hello world itself, then make it as a all file type, this all file type, right? So make it as all file type, and then give a file name as hello world, and then you need to also give a dot java extension. That's a very important step. Since we are doing it Java, so just we are giving a dot java extensions and make it as all file type, then just simply click on save, and you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly formatted over here, right? So now you need to do one more step. So for that, I have already created this code snippet, so I'll be again putting this entire code in the description. So here what we are doing is, we are first going inside this current directory, then we are going to use the file name, that is hello world, to compile our program, and then we'll exit if there is any error, and if there is no error, then we are going to run it, right? So this is just a simple code snippet that I have written. So just, you know, simply select all, then right click on it and copy. So this is what code you'll be getting in the descriptions. And now you need to just simply go inside these plugins, then just, you know, simply click on this npp execute, and then you'll be getting this execute NppExec script. So just simply click on that and this will open this window. So inside this commands, just simply right click on it and paste. Right, and then just simply click on OK. So after clicking OK only, this will going to run. So let's say you modified something. Let's say you change this hello world to hello everyone, for instance. And now if you just simply save it, and if you just simply go to plugin, then this execute script, and then just simply click on OK, you can see it has rightly executed with our hello everyone in our console. Right. So in this way, you can easily run any Java program in Notepad++ itself. So we have rightly shown you how to install that plugin and how to run your Java program inside Notepad++ itself. Right. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and so please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.